Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to this second webinar on Microsoft Teams and doing the things with Teams that you've never done before. My name is Bart de Horst. I'm a CSM here at Microsoft. And today we're going to show you the wonderful world of Microsoft Teams and getting more out of Teams than just the things that you probably are using it for today. I want to start off with some generic rules. If you want to ask us a question, please use the chat for that. We try to answer as most questions as possible. Not sure if we can answer every question, but we'll do our best. And with that, I want to take it away and start with zooming in a little bit on what happened in the last year. Of course, COVID changed everything for a lot of people in the world. And for Microsoft, we see that in more or less three different phases. So it began when the pandemic hit with the response phase. So how are we going to navigate in the new normal in what's happening now? The second phase, which started directly after that, is how are we going to recover? How are we going to cope with all the different lockdowns and you name it? So we want to plan actually coming back to a new normal. And now we're actually at the beginning of what we call the reimagined phase. So we want to think about how are we going to shape the new normal, the new ways of working with each other. And what we see there is that Teams is really playing a very big role in that. Of course, also for us, we saw that the usage of Teams really spiked. And at the moment, we are seeing more than 150 million people every day on Microsoft Teams. And part of the imagining a new normal is that we want to look beyond chatting in Teams. We want to look beyond just sharing a file in Teams and making your phone calls in Teams. There's so much more possible with Microsoft Teams. And that's something we want to zoom in on today. So what you probably are using Teams for is you want to stay connected, you want to collaborate with your colleagues. But there's more to that. And that's what we call integrating various business processes in Teams. And of course, on a very secure and compliant way. And just to start up with one, what we call a quick win, a very great example of that is, for example, integrating your SharePoint content in Teams. So leveraging the existing content that you already have in Microsoft Teams. And this is an example of a Microsoft intranet running on SharePoint. And this is an example of how we're using that internally within Microsoft. So as you can see, we have our intranet site, and you can click on the little globe in the top right of your screen if you want to go to your browser and then access SharePoint from there. But you can also integrate it almost seamlessly in the left rail in Teams. So as you can see there, there's a Microsoft logo with the title Microsoft. That's something you can adapt to your own organization with your own logo and then linking it to your own existing content that's already there. This is a very quick, very cool quick win and very fast quick win to make sure that you leverage the content that's already there in an application that's already been used by a lot of people probably in your organization. If you want to read more about that, we have this website. If you go to aka.ms/adoption-hub, that's where you can see some examples of how to leverage SharePoint content in Teams. And with that, actually, I want to hand it over to some very cool other examples of leveraging Teams as a platform. And I want to hand it over to Arjan.
Well, thank you very much, Bart. Thank you for having us here today as part of the Teams as a Platform campaign. And also thank you for leaving my home office for the first time since many months.
Yeah, glad to have you here, of course.
To be here at the Microsoft building in this studio. So this webinar is being hosted by Microsoft, of course, and Mixit Workplace Buddy and Lifetiles. And we want to take you along the process and the examples and the solutions to create, to make Teams more as a personal productivity platform. So that's what we're going to talk about the next 60 minutes. And before we get into all the examples, I want to elaborate a little bit more about what Bart just now said. And he showed us that the Teams platform has been used a lot for video conferencing, for chat functionality. And we've seen the rise in number of users with the same numbers as Bart just now showed us. So we see a huge increase, but people who use it primarily for the video conference and chat. At the same time, we also see, and that's the stats at the right-hand corner, that people who work from home have been doing a lot more in a lot of things in the last year. More email, more chat, more meetings, etc. So first of all, this raises the question, are we doing well? Are we working too much? Are people happy? What does it do with our, how we, experience this new digital workplace, as I must say. And at the same time, it also raises the question, what are the opportunities for teams to explore as a platform? McKinsey has investigated this and has shown us that we do not rise to that, potential that that we can have by working from home. And if you look at the next phase, as you also mentioned just now, there will be something, we call it hybrid or not, but probably there will be some kind of mix between working at the office, working at home, or maybe some other location. And this means that we need to figure out how we can give all our employees that feeling, that functionality, that solution, that they can really get the most out of it. And one of the reasons I think is that it's so difficult is because there's a huge gap between the possibility of technology and what we as humans can do, can absorb and can learn. And Gartner has shown us some statistics about this. And this gap, they call it the digital dexterity gap, which actually shows that we are not able to cope with the speed, maybe the lightning speed of technology that we see and will even continue in the next decade. So if we understand that this is a problem, how do we face this problem and how do we solve it so that we help our users to benefit from all this beautiful functionality? And we think this requires a translation from humans to technology and vice versa. And by understanding the possibilities of technology, and they are endless, I would say, we can almost build and do anything with technology, but it's very difficult to see how it really benefits the end user. And that's what we need to do. So today, Mixit Lifestyles and Workplace Buddy will show you some of the examples and the learnings that we have had in the last couple of years to solve this problem. And I want to start off with a question for all the people in the webinar, and please use the chat functionality to give your answer. And we'll be back in a couple of moments from Bart. But the question is, when innovating our workplace, we forget to start with the end user and translate their needs to solutions. Well, does this apply for you? Then please answer an A. If you say, well, we know we have to do it, but we lack the capacity or knowledge, then please type in the B. And C, if you think you're doing a great job by putting the end user first and think about him or her when designing your solution. All right. If you look at the three ingredients that we think you should carry out to make that translation work for you, we look at fit for purpose, adoption, and last, to measure all your results with the KPIs that you've set. So if we zoom in a little bit more and look at fit for purpose, I think it's very important that we design or distinguish the target groups within the organization and translate them first or design them into personas. And the example that I would like to give is that when looking at consumer brands, we tend to analyze our consumers very well, their behavior. We design our customer journeys and touch points and all these things in order to give them the best solution, product or service whatsoever. But we do not always do that for our employees. So we give them some technology, but we don't really know how they will use it, in which way, and what we want to solve. So the first thing to have to make that final translation is to know your end users, to know your people, and to translate it into a persona. So fit for purpose, as a short summary, is to understand the organization. They set the boundaries, they set the objectives, the ambition, the KPIs, and how does it translate to the end user? And of course, I want to stress that the third part is technology, because somewhere in the triangle organization, humans and technology, you'll have to find the solution. And if you have that knowledge, you can prototype your solution, you can validate it with your users before you even implement it. And you can do that very quickly. By doing that, you probably have your solution as much as you need it, but then you need to add something else to it, because only with the solution, only the technical solution is not enough. You need certain rules, you need certain guidelines, you need governance. You need to think about the content that runs through your platform, who owns it, and what are the rules for that. And everything, if you add that to that solution, will help you creating that fit for purpose. And that means actually having a solution that is fit for the right person in his or her job, doing whatever the organization requires them to do. So that's step one. And I want to make a short, give you an example of how things happen in the e-commerce world. I don't know for our English speaking viewers who are not in the Netherlands, but we have a web shop which is called Coolblue. And they actually help us buying televisions and all kinds of electronic devices. Yeah. And they do that in a very good way as one of the market leaders. But what they also do is they spend a lot of money in their SEO, in Google, in their television advertisements, etc., everywhere, to attract customers to their websites. And why do I mention this? Because I also think that the solution that you have does not automatically is not automatically seen by all your employees. So you have to bring your solution to the employees. You have to make sure they know about it, that they are informed about the benefits, that you reach them actually in their emotion, that you that they are motivated to use that solution, that they see what are the benefits for them personally, that you enable them, so you have to train them in using the right functionality, and furthermore you have to start doing, and which means actually using it, but also stop doing something you did before, because maybe you have to really change your way of working. And last but not least, not only doing it for a week or for a month, but doing it for a long time, which means you have to measure statistics, use the data to improve your solution on one side, but also improve your adoption strategy on the other side. And one thing you can maybe help you in making that visual is by designing a so-called adoption campaign, success campaign, communication campaign, whatever words you want to use. And what it actually means is that you translate the needs of your organization to a campaign that is targeted specifically for your employees. Because it doesn't matter if you implement Teams today or a new CRM next month or a new way of authenticating through MFA in a half year. Every time, this project requires the right communication to your employees. And instead of doing it every time as a new project, I think it's better to design a more of a generic approach. So by having this campaign, which is specifically set for your organization, you can use it every time again and again, and improve it by learning from the statistics. Then you design your means and you use them for the right target group as you want them. So if you look at change and adoption, to summarize, have your plan ready, involve your leadership, they can make it or break it. So please pay attention to that. Of course, ambassadors is something that we or maybe a lot of people have said before, but you have to have them, keep them involved all the time. Make your information, everything that you do, make it personal based on your persona, and measure your results through the KPIs that you've set at the beginning. Then I want to get back to the example of Coolblue, because what Coolblue does, or any other a successful web shop, is they help us, and of course it's commercially driven, but they help us in making the right choice for the product that we want. And actually we can have the same way of thinking to help our employees choose the right functionality they need to solve their daily issues, their problems, their objectives they have in their work. And by creating a sort of a store, and in this store we have these solutions which are not only the technical solution, but also my training, my digital adoption platform, the tips and tricks, instruction videos, comments from other colleagues, they would help me in using that solution that I need. So for example, we would see here a certain role, somebody who is in management role, is looking for a certain scenario that they want to explore. This is collaborating together. They see certain solutions, applications, trainings that are scheduled, other services, some colleagues who could have the expert status. And finally, they say, okay, wait a minute, I want to collaborate in a project. So how do I do that? And if you go on, you will find here specific information how to collaborate in projects, which things I have to discuss with my co-workers, how do I keep my documents in order, can I include an application like Trello in Teams, etc., etc., etc. So this is your communication, your store, targeted for your employees, for the solutions they have. And that should be the whole, cover everything that's in your organization, from Teams to your smart boards, to your laptops, to your our registration application, whatever it may be, this is the way you could help your employees. So what I've done is I've tried to give you an understanding why it is so difficult to make, to close the gap between technology and your employees. What is the reason behind it, and how we can make that step, closing that gap by looking at our employees, creating a fit for purpose, taking them along the path of communication and adoption, and measure the results. Well, I hope this gives you some guidance in making the right choices. And obviously, to make that choice, I would like to hand over the word to Tim from LiveTask, who will show you which applications, which choice you can make to integrate into Teams.
Yeah. And just before you start, Tim.
Of course.
The answer was C. The again. Most people, yeah, again. Yeah. So a lot of consistency there.
I'm very happy with that. So that means that a lot of organizations are already thinking about putting the employee first. And of course, today it may be difficult to talk to all of you one-on-one, but I'd really love to know what your experiences are. So can you also close that gap? Do you see that it's easy or difficult? What are the results? So maybe you can share them in the chat. And later on, I think if we have some time, maybe Bart, we can even answer some of your personal questions. So thank you.
Thanks, Arjan. Thanks, Bart. And thanks, Microsoft, for having me here in this webinar. It's great to be able to show a bit more about our solutions from a LiveTask perspective. As Arjan mentioned, we are a partner of Mixit, but we're also a gold partner of Microsoft. And I'd like to explain a bit more to you about, you know, how we work and what we do. So first of all, LiveTask is a software provider. We build solutions that really integrate into the platform of Microsoft, which means that we integrate into Teams, we integrate into SharePoint, and we make use of the best features and functionalities and user experience of the platform. And we add functionality to it from a LiveTask perspective, where we think that the platforms can improve or, you know, can use some more functionality. I really, you know, like the scene that basically has been set by Mixit and by Arjan just before. I fully believe in that digital dexterity is one of the big issues that we're dealing with. And also what Bart said, we are dealing with, you know, the reimagining phase of a digital workplace. We see more and more that intranets are, you know, fading away out of the landscape. And we see more and more that Teams is picking up the role where the internet used to sit. And this is actually one of the challenges that we try to tackle and try to work with from a LiveTask perspective. So to give you a bit of an insight into what we do at LiveTask and how we work is basically, when it comes to Teams, we try to make this more user-centric. So we try to look at how can we more personalize Teams. I mean, it's a great platform to work in documents. It's great to video call, to chat, to work together with colleagues. But there's a lot more that, you know, fits into the digital workplace that you're currently using. And we believe that we can bring that functionality to Teams. And by doing that, we can make this, you know, a more, you know, less complex digital workplace and make, you know, Teams the central hub where you can do everything that you need to do on a daily basis. And obviously, we fully underpin that, you know, we need to look at these different personas. We need to look at, you know, their level of digital maturity, and that we need to understand how people do their work. Because in the end, what we want to achieve is that they become more productive, that they start, you know, doing more collaboration from the Teams platform, and they find their peers and colleagues and expertise more easily. So with these goals in mind, that's what we try to achieve from a LiveTiles perspective. And today we'll bring you on board two of our main solutions that we have developed for Teams, which is LiveTiles Reach, really a content management platform, and LiveTiles Everywhere, which really sits as an integration hub to simplify your digital workplace as it is. So to start off with using Teams as a communication platform, as I already mentioned, we're doing a lot of work on the collaboration side within Teams. We video call, we chat, we find our peers, and we start working in documents together. But we still have that big intranet functionality when it comes to news and notifications that we haven't really fit into Teams yet, because Teams basically is a siloed approach to communicating and working. So what if we could bring a content management solution to Teams that allows you to communicate with different types of employees, and not just the office workers, but really also your frontline employees, and get them connected and start working together through the Teams platform? Well, how would that look? Let's have a look at Michelle. Michelle is a retail store manager, and she's one of the personas that we can identify using the digital workplace more and more often. When you're working in a store, you normally don't have access to a laptop. You don't have access to a personal desktop, but you normally would use your phone a lot more. So what you could do is really start to tailor the solution to this way of using it. And what would she want to do? What would Michelle like to have access to in order to improve, her job and her role within the organization? Well, for example, she might want to be more engaged with what's going on in the company. What are some successes that we can celebrate? And how can we maybe tailor the customer experience a bit more to their needs? There's a lot we can learn from news and information that sits normally on your internet that we should be able to bring to Teams as well, so that they'll be able to use either the Teams app or the LiveTiles Reach app to get to that information. So just to give you a bit of an idea of what this looks like, I have a demo prepared for you. And if we switch to the demo right now, you'll see that in the screen we have a pop-up showing up here in Teams, which basically brings the whole content management solution to Teams. So on the left side here, you'll see the Reach app, which is pinned on the Teams bar, which is obviously accessible just through one click. And once we've clicked on it, this screen will pop up where we'll have all the news and information sitting here on a personalized basis. So what we do is we look at the profile and Active Directory of an end user, and based on where they work, what kind of job they do, what kind of expertise they have, obviously their right managements, we'll be able to provide them information and notifications based on what they need to be able to do their job properly. So if we scroll down here, we can see all these different news items sitting here in the timeline, and all of them are tagged with metadata, and all of these news items are tagged to specific user groups as well. So if I would go up to the top here, we can select channels of news that we want to engage with, or we can filter on metadata if we use the filter setting on the right top here. So this allows end users to quick and easily access news that is relevant for them, and they'll be able to find information that could help them improve in their job. Obviously, we find it very important that highlighted notifications like IT issues or maybe something related to health and safety in terms of COVID are being highlighted in the news stream as well, and people will get a notification either in Teams or on their mobile phone once something is shared like that. So this is where we have the highlight notifications sitting on the top, and if we click on them, obviously the news feature will open up and we can read the highlights, and we could also make people confirm that they've read it so that they're so that we know and their managers know that we've actually been informed. So going back to the mainstream, obviously we can select all of these different news items. We can open them up, we can read them. If we scroll down, you'll see you'll be able to comment, you can like, we can actually show analytics on how many people have been able to read up on it. And we can even share it on different platforms if we want to. The great thing about this is you don't have to leave Teams. Also, if you want to create news, we can actually go into the Reach application in Teams and click the pen button on the right top and select a new article and start building a new news item. So what we could do is maybe add like an image. We've done integrations with, for example, Unsplash, and we can select any kind of image and add this to the news item. And from here, we can start entering more information. For example, if you want to enter contact details, if you want to enter any quotes, maybe some videos or information, everything can be done here right within Teams using the content management system of Reach. We can also ask people to obviously confirm that they've read this. If it's necessary, we can switch on and off the comment and like functionality. In this way, we basically are allowing communication officers and communication managers to use Teams as their central content management platform as well. Now, if you're working in different languages, we also have the option to set up translations. So here on the left top, you'll see that this news item is actually set up in English, but we can also switch this on to, for example, Dutch or French or Italian, basically any kind of language you want. Based on the user profile, we'll show you exactly the news item and the content that is switched to your language based on the profile properties. And news is not the only thing that we can actually set up here. We can also provide HR information, for example, within Teams, or maybe information from an IT team or a communications team by using the pages setup. So the pages setup is really meant to get people to read up on policies, for example, to make sure that they're up to date on the latest health and safety procedures, that they know that if they want to request some time off, we can then link them to the right HR information and platforms to find the information on how to set this up. So for example, if we go to the employee handbook, we can then find all these different documents and all these different policies that we can open up. And these can be read within Teams without actually having to leave the application. So just to give you a bit of an example, here we have a conduct policy, which we can find all the general guidelines. And we can even link people to, for example, HR applications through Teams. So if you want to request some time off, just click on the on the link in it, and we will basically single sign on you into the HR application where employees can use their mobile phone to request time off or maybe book some sick leave if they want to.
If I might interrupt real quick, Tim, I see some questions coming in.
Yeah.
If you already have some existing SharePoint content, is it something you can integrate in your solution as well?
Absolutely, yeah. So there's a connection that works two ways within mm-hmm. Reach, which means that we can push content from Reach into SharePoint, or we can bring SharePoint content into Teams.
Yeah.
And if you want to, we're also able to integrate soon within Viva. As soon as Viva comes out, we'll be able to reach, to push Reach content into Viva as well.
Okay, great, thanks.
Yeah. Another example of what you can do within Reach is setting up events. So this is something different from using your Outlook calendar items, obviously. This is really about getting people to sign up for events, maybe register for a Friday afternoon drink session, or maybe sign up for a training. And we can basically ask everyone to register for these, and we can set up either physical locations or online locations for people to visit. So this way we know who's registered. We know, for example, then if people want to create a community within the stores or the group of stores they work in, they can work together and set up these events without needing the intervene of the head office. So these are a few examples of what we can do within Reach, and obviously there's a lot more to tell. So we really like to engage with you if you want to know more on the application. We really like to show you a lot more, but Arjan will tell you a bit more about that in the at the end of the session. Reach can be used as a mobile app as well. So the great thing about that is if you want to engage with people that might not have access to Microsoft Teams yet, we can use this to push content through a mobile app and allow these users to plug into their Microsoft Digital Workplace using the Reach app. And obviously we can brand this to your liking. So we can set up the color schemes, we can change the logos and make sure you can access everything, as you can see right here on the screen at the moment. So to go back to the presentation, just to sum up, I've just shown you LifeTiles Reach, which is really a tool that we can use for news, setting up HR policies, making sure that we've got events. And if you do not want to use the chat functionality of Teams, we can add this into LifeTiles Reach as well. But obviously that's on a case-by-case setup. Now, I've got a question on this for you, because when we obviously talk about bringing communications into Teams, it's really about rethinking your whole intranet strategy. Are you still using your intranet in SharePoint, for example, to bring people to read the news? Or do you think that Teams might be able to solve that issue for you once you start using the Reach tooling? So I'd really like to hear from you whether you think, yes, we can replace the current engagement setup by setting up something like Reach in Teams, and we can bring, you know, a personalized new stream that way, and we can redefine our internet within Teams. Or do you think, you know, not sure, maybe, you know, we need to depend on also how the communication strategy is set up and how we do the content management? Or do you think now we really need to stick to the classic internet, we need to stick within SharePoint, and we'll just be using Teams for collaboration? So I'd really like to hear from you on that.
I'll get back to you on the answers on these questions.
Great. So the next application I would like to show you is LiveTiles Everywhere. So Teams really shines when it comes to collaboration, when it comes to working together. But what if we can actually use Teams in a broader way by also bringing content from external systems into your Teams platform? It would make a lot of sense not having to switch back and forth between apps. For example, if you're looking for documents and you cannot find them, normally you'd have to go to SharePoint to use the Microsoft 365 search functionality. Or you might be having to look for expertise using an org chart that doesn't sit in Team. Or maybe you want to, you know, bring up some notifications that are now popping up in your HR screen or in your email. What if you can bring that all to Teams using an integration hub? And that's basically what LiveTiles Everywhere does. And again, we started thinking about, you know, what personas would be using this and what would be the challenges that that they run into. So here we have Sarah, who is a project support employee, and she works a lot from Teams already. We can see project support employees using Teams for, you know, document collaboration, to start video calling and chatting with their peers. But they also find a lot of information like tasks or notifications popping up in different systems, which means that they need to shift from Teams to the other applications to find that, which can be, you know, reducing your focus, and reduced focus times obviously means less productivity, less efficiency. And what if we can improve that experience for the employees? So here we can show you LiveTiles Everywhere, which is another app that we've added to the Teams platform. And you can see this on the screen right here. So LiveTiles Everywhere is another app that can be added to the bar on the left here. And it basically presents you a simplified hub that brings information from backend applications like your HR system or maybe your IT ERP systems, or maybe even SharePoint, into Teams in a personalized view. So here we can see on the top all the different modules that have been set up personalized based on the needs of the employee. So this could really, you know, change from, you know, the types of role that you have, or the expertise you might have, or any kind of requirements you might have within Teams in terms of your digital workplace. If we scroll down, we can see the same modules popping up here in the home screen of LiveTiles Everywhere. Now let's pick some examples. For example, I want to integrate all my notifications into one overview. So what if I would have an IT system that tells me, hey, we're going to have a blackout at the end of today because we want to upgrade our servers and infrastructure. We could bring that notification into Teams, which means that you'll be informed right in the place where you start working. And we can do the same for HR information, like, for example, if your payslip is up and ready, or if your holiday hours have been approved. We can bring all these notifications into this notification hub using the LiveTiles API to bring all that content together into one overview. Another thing where we use our LiveTiles API is to set up the enterprise search, which is quite a new feature. As most of you know, the search in SharePoint is excellent, but we're not having access to that search quite easily in the Teams environment. So what if we can bring that enterprise search to Teams? So for example, if I want to know more about marketing and I'm looking for documents, or I'm looking for people in marketing, I can actually use the search feature that LiveTiles is providing here by separating different types of content entities, for example, people, sites, content, or whatever kind of metadata you want to collect. So this way we can actually search for properties like pages or documents, preview them, or find people with specific expertise to improve collaboration and to improve finding knowledge that you need to have on the fly and more quickly finish your work on the project, for example. again, we're using the API to bring all this content together, which means that you will not have to access these backend systems as much anymore, and you can stay working in Teams as your preferred application. Other things we can do are, for example, setting up personalized links. So we can provide you access to backend applications if you do not want to access them from within Teams. So this way you can quickly navigate to wherever and whenever you want to be. And one final feature I want to show you is the people directory. So what if you're looking for specific colleagues with specific expertise, like someone with SharePoint expertise? I can actually go and search for them. And because there is a profile management bot linked to this application, we'll be able to find the colleagues that will have SharePoint as expertise in their profile. Or if I'm looking for someone from the IT department, I'll be able to find my colleagues that work in that department. Now, all of these people will manage their profiles using the profile bot that we've set up in Teams. So they can set up, for example, their phone numbers, their addresses, but also add up extra information to their Active Directory, like skills or projects that they're working on, so that we can find them more easily and we can share expertise within the company.
And that bot is used to, for example, if you haven't filled in your phone number, that bot will ask you like, hey, Tim, what's your phone number, right?
Exactly. Yep. So here on the screen, you'll see the profile management suite. So this is my profile. Here you can see this one is already 100% complete. But if I would miss information, I could actually update this information using the pop-up, which basically means that the bot will pop up in Teams and will request you to fill out the data if it's either incorrect or missing. One final thing to show is bringing together tasks. So if you are a project employee, you might have a lot of deadlines and tasks you want to work on. Normally they sit either in Outlook or you have them in To-Do or you might have some in SharePoint. Again, the Lifetiles API can bring them all together into one overview, providing an overview of all of your tasks that need to be finished or maybe policies that you might have to read before you continue working or any kind of pages you want to revisit or have to check upon if you're a content manager, for example. So this way we really improve the power of the Teams platform and really bring this into a full workplace suite where you can basically do all of your core tasks without having to leave the Teams application.
Just see another question coming in. This is a very cool app. Can you perhaps share some light on how to distribute this app so as not then to all your end users?
Yeah, so is that regarding the Everywhere app or the Reach app?
I see just a question, okay. How do you distribute the app?
It's quite easy, actually. We install the apps on Azure. So once it's installed on Azure, then we can plug this into Teams. So it comes up available in the app catalog, and then you can start using it.
Okay, yeah, and probably as an admin, you can also pin it for a specific group of end users.
Yeah.
So you as an end user do not have to go to the App Store, which reduces the barrier, of course, to actually use it, right?
Yeah, exactly. So Everywhere we can make available instantly. We can do the same for Reach, but with Reach, if you do not want to use the app within Teams, but if you want to use it as a standalone app, for example, if someone does not have access to a Teams license, then we can invite them using their private email. So if they don't have a company email, we can use the Hotmail address or live email address to invite them.
Okay, thanks.
So to summarize, Lifetiles Everywhere is really a powerful solution to integrate information, to personalize modules and personalize teams to bring data and information together, unify this, and obviously to bring expertise together within the company without having to leave Teams. That kind of was my demo here today. Bart, do you have any feedback on the questions?
I do have feedback on the questions. I see that the most people have filled in answer C.
C. Yeah. Okay, so they do still believe that they can stick to the classic internet.
Yeah, but it's about 50-50. Also, I also see that a lot of people are filling in answer B. So it's almost a par.
Okay, well, I'm happy to challenge you. Obviously, we start to think differently about internets, and we really want to to show you how things can be done in a different way. It might take a bit of a different mindset, but yeah, I'm here to challenge you in any way I can.
It's all part of the reimagine phase, right?
Exactly. If you don't progress, you basically run backwards. So yeah, that's it.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Tim. And thank you for sharing us some ideas on how to add functionality, add applications to the Teams platform in order to make it more useful, more productive. Then we're going to ask Sjoerd to tell us how we can really start using it in the right way and how your tool can help us.
All right, thank you so much. My name is Sjoerd, which is pronounced as a short with two O's, Sjoerd, so that would do it. I used to be an adoption consultant at Microsoft Services before, so I used to work here, and now I'm the founder of Workplace Buddy. Before we continue, we're going to start with a statement which is all about fun, because fun is important. Well, that's what I think, and we're very curious what you think. To what extent is fun important to connect with your colleagues in your organization? Is that A, yes, it is important. We should really make use of it to engage with people. B, nah, not so much, but a smile is okay. Or C, well, let's go to the theater to have our laughter later on when that's possible again. We're happy to be hearing from you, and we'll be discussing that later on. First, let's proceed with Workplace Buddy, because what we experienced and what we see around is that many employees have struggles on what to use when, why to use it, but also how to make use of the tools that are available. And when you want to offer support, it's really hard to be available for everybody continuously, and also to answer the questions that people continuously have. And for that reason, we came up with Workplace Buddy, which is a white label Teams app that helps people well, to make use of Microsoft 365 in a fun and engaging way. And we do that as follows. We start with the scan, and there we ask a couple of questions about your persona, but also about your digital readiness level. What I used to do as a person, I interviewed 10 people within organizations. But well, there were way more people. And now with Workplace Buddy, we can interview everybody to get a better understanding of the workforce and to get a better understanding of all individuals' needs. And with this understanding, we can provide you a personal learning journey that's tailored to your individual needs. With e-learnings that take roughly 2 to 3 minutes and are about the topics that you think is interesting. Also, we offer proactive campaigns. We can identify target audiences that we think are relevant and send proactive messages, just like the one-on-one chat experience, to you with relevant e-learnings. And this really increases engagement of our platform, but also of the Microsoft 365 platform, obviously. And last but not least, we answer questions. So we do that through the chatbot, but also follow up on questions that the chatbot did not know before. And we make sure that a notification is received to the original person who asked this question. It looks a bit like this. So this is the scan. We ask a couple of questions about your persona, about your digital readiness level to identify your digital dexterity. Your persona is somewhat like your profile and what is important in your daily lives, right? Are you into making or checking off lists? Are you into making notes? Are you into communicating a lot with people? Are you into presenting? That kind of stuff gives us an idea of who you are. And that makes it possible for us to provide you a personal learning journey that's tailored to your individual needs. A learning takes 2 to 3 minutes and influences your profile when you finish it. We work together with Microsoft Learning Pathway. So we're one of the 5 worldwide partners, and we create our own e-learnings as well to make sure we're always up to date. Last but not least, we answer questions. We do that through the chatbot. In this example, you can see a question is being answered along with an e-learning. So without leaving the conversation, you can see the e-learning and finish it, which again, influences your profile, which influences the suggestions that we proactively come up with. We see all statistics in the platform in the backend. So there you can see how your workforce is doing and what you can do to improve your adoption tactics. So that's how we work together with our partners. So benefits, we make it possible that adoption is offered continuously to everybody in a personal and fun way. And we make sure that your Microsoft 365 investment is really utilized. And the major business case is on the support tickets that we prevent, but also on productivity increase. And we do that through the scan, where we get to understand who you are, through the personal learning journey that's tailored to your individual needs, through the proactive engagement campaigns and answers to your questions. That was it.
Thank you very much, Tim. I see just one question coming in.
Short.
I saw also a lot of feedback coming in on the pronunciation, but I'll leave that for now. Is there a minimum amount of knowledge needed before you can start with this application?
Well, with all content, we focus on Microsoft 365, and that's being improved every day, right? Mm-hmm. So that's already it works when your focus is on Microsoft 365, like ours is. But from the back end, it's possible to add your own content as well. You can add your own e-learnings, you can add your own question answer pairs, you can add your own engagement campaigns, and stuff like that. So it depends on what additional topics you'd like to add.
Cool. Very cool to hear. It's great to hear that it's also customizable and to really meet the needs of that for your specific organization.
Yep.
Cool.
Thank you, Short.
I thought it was pronounced Tim, but
that's easier.
I want to finalize this this webinar, and for the people who are present today. LiveTiles, Workplace Buddy, and Mixit have the following offering. We want to take you into a half-day deep dive, and this means that in that time, we really want to focus on fit for purpose and adoption. Obviously, to just touch on the possibilities and the ambition that you have as an organization and where you are in closing that gap. Secondly, in the LiveTiles portfolio, which of the products, and Tim has shown you two of them, could enhance your team's platform. And third, get some hands-on experience with Workplace Buddy and LiveTiles Reach to see that you have your own experience with the platform, with the apps within the platform. So if you want this, sign up. This can be done through the chat within this webinar. Or you can send me an email, and we will follow up on this this week. And thanks from myself, from Tim, and from Sjoerd. This is his real name, how it's written. And thank you for your time. If there are no more questions, Bart.
You just can click on the button one more time.
Yeah.
You can see the recordings of this session and also previous sessions on by clicking by entering these URLs in your browser. And thank you very much. Also for me, an opportunity to come back to the office one more time. So thank you very much for that. And I hope you enjoyed the session. Thank you.